in. Trocheck with a drop pass. Ekblad drops for Jokinen. Now Demers. Riley Smith lets one go and score! Power play goal for the Panthers.
I gotta tell you, Riley Smith has been trying to hit that top shelf for 3 months, and he's been practicing for 3 months. In Winnipeg, he scored a power play goal, top shelf, right there, off the crossbar and the goalpost. And again, same spot. That's where he beat the goaltender. Outstanding. It looked like he beat him clean. I'm not sure. Now, I don't think that Trocheck touched it, but again, that top shelfer is where he's been aiming for a while, and he's getting rewarded.
5-2, 2-1, an overtime win over the Red Wings at the Joe. Here's Mantha, scores! It's a tie game! Mantha closed the scoring in the loss at Tampa, and he's opened the scoring for the Red Wings. Further south in Sunrise, and it took just 12 seconds into period two, and the game's tied at one.
Outstanding individual play with the read. Watch the skill play there, and he lights the lamp. Does Mantha with a nice individual effort, comes across the slot and beats Roberto Luongo, a low blocker.
So Anthony Mantha gets his sixth goal and his 11th point in 19 games.
Throws one wide. Jágr plays the carom off the end boards. Takes a bump from Vanek. Barkov has it. Comes to Demers with a shot. Score! Jason Demers! And it's 2-1 Panthers.
All right, any of you at home are saying, boy, we're tired of hearing those broadcasters say, shoot the puck. That was not a shot to score. That was a shot to get it to the net, to try and create a rebound of some sort. Look, he's on one leg, and the bad leg is shooting the puck. But when you get to the net and it hits the net, you never know what's going to happen. Number six for Demers.
And 1889 for Jágr gets the second assist.
Sevier brings it ahead. Colton Sevier. In and out of the glove. Oh, got just enough of it.
Block. Thompson in front. We'll feed it back to the point. Matheson. And they score! Derek McKenzie from Matheson.
Michael Matheson this time found a target with no Detroit player all around him, and that was Derek McKenzie, the captain. And of course, you've got to know where to go to find that spot. You've got to find some open ice right here. Why is that? Well, once you fill it and nobody's coming after you, you are home free. Find that open ice, find the white ice, and hopefully somebody will find you. And Matheson did. What a pass. I mean, he had to get that over top of the sticks and lay it down for Derek McKenzie, who's putting in his fourth.
And it comes out of his zone as the Red Wings are on this brief power play. Now Barkov set to come back, but it opens up for Vanek. And Luongo with a big save. Panthers are in a change, and Vanek had a great chance.
Had nowhere to go. It's just played at the center. Found its way to Larkin and a bouncer in that Athanasiou will chase down. Athanasiou protects that puck into the slot. Across, shot, scores! What a great pass across, and Drew Miller buries his third of the season. It's 3-2 with plenty of time left.
Lots of skill on display in this hockey game. Chip in charge. Larkin to Athanasiou. Look him take a peek. Take a peek. Rip it. And Miller could always shoot it. Shows it there. Luongo caught on his goal line. Doesn't come out, doesn't push out, just across. And he knows he was exploited by Drew Miller. We got ourselves a hockey game.
To the point for Cronwall. In front of the goal for Sproul. Vanek in front. Oh, what a save! Rebound! They score! Nielsen! After Nyquist was robbed, Nielsen buries it. Tie game!
there's Nyquist on the faceoff win, and if you know that stat, watch how many people it takes to win a faceoff. Nielsen back to the point. There's three touches. Then it goes to the corner. Sproul activates after he makes the pass down low. Back out front. All three forwards touch it. And we're tied up with 6:09 remaining.
In the shootout in his career, looking for his first as a Red Wing. What a move, what a goal! Franz Nielsen gives the Red Wings the lead. So he tied up the game, has given the Red Wings the lead as Bukestad must score here.
I think they're reviewing that to make sure he didn't touch it twice.
Okay. So in this building, although not every building, there are goal judges behind the nets. Most buildings they are not. This one they are, and the first one, they signaled a goal, and he's right there. That never went in. They may as well be up in the Raptors. Doesn't seem to matter. Does he touch the puck twice or no? Does he push the pad and in? Oh, that's going to be a close one.
It is.
That's going to be a tough call. You cannot push the pad either.
Or was his stick trapped under the pad?
And the puck was going in. This is where,
right?
In conversation with Toronto, the situation room, that's referee Jean Hébert in contact with them to see if Franz Nielsen has given the Red Wings the lead.
It looks worse when you slow it down. You have to remember the speed at which this game is played. From that vantage point, I would say good goal. When you slow it down, you can see all the nuances. Just showed you slow motion. Watch real speed. He's just finishing his move at real speed.
Yeah, it doesn't look like he did twice.
No.
But are they going to determine a push on the pad? But that's just going for the puck. This is not an easy call.
No, it is not. Because, again, at real speed, you can see he's finishing his move.
And a call on the ice is a goal. But again, the situation room not on the tablet here on a coach's challenge where it's the referee's call.
Correct.
In the final 2 minutes and in overtime and then the shootout, the call goes back to the situation room in Toronto. Must be conclusive in their view to overrule what was a goal on the ice. So we wait.
And we've given you fans pretty good perspective. I think it's always fair to show things in real time what the referees are considering and have to deal with. When you slow it down, you can get a completely different interpretation than it is just like this.
We'll get the call from Jean Hébert.
After review the call, we got a good goal.
Okay. Stat. Jared Coral. If he scores, we go on. If he doesn't, Red Wings win. He doesn't. Jared Coral, his first National Hockey League win. And the Red Wings trailed after 2-2, win by 1 in a shootout.